That's right, other guy, I'm up in your studio again, but this time I'm not making videos for the students. I'm making this video for you. See, I was a little afraid when you saw my last video where you learned that you can take this product to square roots, write it as a square root of products. I was afraid that you'd think you could get away with all sorts of wrong stuff, and I can't have you teaching the students wrong stuff. So let's check this out. We'll start right here. Now, I know what you're going to do, other guy. You're going to say, hey, 25 plus 144, that's 169. Those two must be equal. Let's see if you're right. Square root of 25, that's just 5. Square root of 144, that's just 12. 5 plus 12, that's 17. Now, over here, we have the square root of 169. 169 is 13 squared. Square root of 13 squared, that's 13. 17 is not 13. Got that? 17 is not 13. These two are not equal. So here's the key point. We can take this right here, this product of square roots, and we can write it as the square root of product. We can't do the same thing with sums. Got that? Over here, we have the sum of square roots is not the same thing as the square root of this sum, because 17 is not 13. All right, say it with me. 17 is not 13. So the sum of these square roots is not the same thing as the square root of this sum. You know, I don't think you really have this down. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to make you watch me write it down, other guy. And other guy, I want you to write it down while you're watching me write it down, so that way you'll remember it. Here we go. Square root of x plus the square root of y is not the square root of x plus y. All right, got that? Good. All right, let's go on to one more mistake that I don't want you to make when you're teaching the students. Here we go. We got the square root of the sum, a squared plus 15 squared. I know what you want to do. I know you want to say, hey, the square root of 8 squared is 8, and the square root of 15 squared is 15, so these two are equal. Let's check it out. We can compute both of these squares. We get 8 squared is 64, 15 squared is 225. And then we add those two up, we get 289. 64 plus 225 is 289. 289 is 17 squared. Square root is 17 squared. Hey, there's 17 again. Now what do you get over there? That's right, you get not 17. 8 plus 15 is 23. 17, it wasn't 13. It's not 23 either. 17 is not 23. So these two are not equal. And this is what we got here. We got a square root of a sum. We can't just break that up into the square root of the first thing, which here would be x, plus the square root of the second thing, which here would be y. Can't break it up like that. The square root of the sum, x squared plus y squared, is not x plus y. Got that? You know what? I'm going to make sure you have that. I'm going to circle the not there. Make sure you see it. See that other guy? Say it with me. Not. Not. Because 17 is not 23. All right, I want to recap. We'll start off with this. This is true. This is good stuff. We can do a lot of good things with this. You have a product of square roots, it equals the square root of the product. That's good. But we can't do it with sums. 17 is not 13. So the sum of the square roots is not, see the big not there, other guy, is not the square root of the sum. Also, 17 is not 23. So we can't take the square root of a sum and break that up into what you get when you're summing the square roots. All right, it's really important that you understand this, other guy, because I can't have you teaching these students incorrectly, because these students are way too important.